What we're going to do is look at a pretty standard break shot. I want you to pay special attention to the cue ball. Put a little bit of draw on it. It popped up in the air, went back. If you look, I made three balls. And what we're going to do is we're going to look, and I'm going to show you how I did this. The first thing we're going to look at is where the balls are going. Okay, the cue ball is going right into that one ball. Coming back, the one ball is going into the side pocket. The corner balls of the 4 and the 8 are both going to be pocketed. If you watch that 4 ball, it's going to go right into the corner pocket like a rocket. Go ahead and watch how these balls go. Bam! That 8 takes a funny trip around the table, kind of hits that pocket point, goes down in that corner pocket. And there's a science behind this. If you notice, I have a pretty good shot on that 2 ball to start a run out. And I'm playing 6 ball instead of 9 ball. You notice I didn't jump up in the air. I didn't lunge my body forward. I basically, you know, stayed pretty stable. And I'm going to show you how I do that. Once again, we're going to look at me. I'm down in my stance. And we'll go ahead and I'm going to freeze it. And the first thing I want you to pay special attention to is my eyes. My eyes are fixated right on that contact point. The cue ball is in line with that contact point, and I line my body up through the stroke line. And we're going to cover that in a little bit. That third line is my center of mass, which I have my foot, my back foot, right underneath my center of mass. And everything is directed straight towards that contact point. See that triangle? That's formed by all three of those lines. That's the secret to generating as much power as possible. It's maximum effectiveness with minimal effort. Okay, what we're going to do, we're going to find the stroke line. And the very first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to find where I've been breaking from. See, I got these break lines right here on the table here. I'm going to put my cue ball right where I usually put it. And I'm just going to kind of forget about it for now, and I'm going to go up here to the rack. And the way I find the stroke line, and I don't know if I'm unique with this, but I always look for a point that's actually beyond the one ball. And what I go for is this diamond right here. And I'm going to get some pictures of exactly what it looks like from my vantage point and put it in the video. You're probably looking at it now. But I take the inside of this diamond right here and I go right through the one ball, right through the center of the one ball. And I remember that. So I go right to the center of the one ball as it lines up to that diamond. And I just kind of go back here to where it lines up with the cue ball. So basically, my line is going just through the one ball and right in front of that diamond. So that's where I'm going to line my body up with. So when I get back here, the first thing I'm going to do is the back foot, my heel of my shooting side, this side here, is going to be in line with that stroke line. Okay? I'm a little close right now. I like to keep this leg straight. I know a lot of players like to kick up off of it, but I've learned that if you've got the heel lined up, it doesn't matter if you sit still like I do or kick off, as long as that back heel is in line with this contact point through the stroke line, you're going to generate your power through that line.
Okay, you see me lining this break up. Getting my foot in line, and I'm going to generate all my power straight at the contact point on that one ball. And let's go ahead and break that down. Let's look at the stroke line going right through the diamond. That's my line for my eyes. And there's my center of mass line. And you see how the cue ball jumps up in the air? It's a little exaggerated. I don't do that all the time. But it's a very effective break. Made a couple of balls and got a makeable shot on the one ball. Here's another power break. And go ahead and break this one down and look at the stroke line going straight through the one ball in the rack towards the diamond. You see the other lines in the power triangle. I go right through there, and I only hit these at maybe 60 to 70% of my total power. I'm not the biggest guy in the world. I'm maybe, you know, 5 foot 10, 185 pounds. I'm not throwing my body into it. I'm using a regular sneaky Pete, a P-shower sneaky Pete. It's not a break cue. I'm able to make, you know, four balls on the break. And it's all in the accuracy and the mechanics. And we'll go ahead and look at this last one. Here I stopped the cue ball right off of the one. Just like that. Made a ball. See how the cue ball is in the center of the table? And go ahead and watch. There's the stroke line. Watch my eyes and my center of mass line. And I'm going to go straight down the middle of that power triangle. Made a ball on the break. I almost make that three ball. Got a little bit unlucky getting a shot on the two ball. But it's important to note that if you start putting some of these tips into your break, if you start using that power triangle and generating all of your power and all your acceleration directly towards that contact point, you're going to start getting the same results as you're seeing in this video.